deposit was made that you couldn't play high school sports. Contact sports were not recommended, but you can play high school sports. And Mark Eula, head of the MHSA, was on the morning show to talk about this, talk about the timeline, talked about the reasons why. One of the topics that came up was the fact that they were playing in Indiana and Ohio, but not Michigan, and that helped them make the decision. Here's what he said.
I'm not sure if it put pressure, but certainly that was a new data room. Our council had to make the decision back on the 14th of August. We didn't have any history of what was going on in other states because everybody was either waiting to start or hadn't started yet. When we start next Tuesday, we're going to be either the 33rd or the 34th state that is playing home football. There are 25 other states currently that are practicing and playing games on the course. And I'm sure it helped. There are two neighbors to the south. Indiana was actually last night. Tonight is already week three of their season. In Ohio, their games last night and tonight, that's week two for them. And in both of those states report that all the football schools playing this fall, they're having 95% plus who have participated in each of the first 2 or 3 weeks of their season. So it's not like they're having outbreaks. It's not like they're having teams that have to quarantine or forfeit games. Another league in a smaller state, they've got 100 football playing schools. And for the third week in a row, 99 of their 100 schools are playing this week. So certainly that data from other places in the country, many of which have far more concerning COVID numbers than we have in Michigan. And that was just another factor where we are confident that we can do it and we can do it as safely as possible.
Right. So, I mean, that helps a little bit. The truth is, I imagine everybody's like us. You've been watching other states. If they do something we haven't tried yet in Michigan, the obvious is, all right, how's that going? Because you're having some success with that. And in this particular case, I keep looking up things like Utah and Ohio and Indiana, and I have not seen any reports of massive outbreaks that have been attributed to football. I mean, these are really, really tough decisions because you never know if you're making a life and death decision for somebody else. Right? Got COVID, that kid can catch COVID, bring it to home, and then it can be problematic for a family member. So, you know, these are really, really tough choices. I don't doubt that the lack of severe spikes and super spreader, you know, football looking like a super spreader in Ohio and Indiana has probably helped because it didn't look like a super spreader.
Yeah, I have no idea what the protocols are with other states, with high school football, what it is in our state with high school football in terms of testing. That, you know, maybe you're not even tested until you show symptoms. I don't know. You know, and I think that's what's... We're finding with numbers of college students that are testing positive, it's because there's testing available to them and they're going to test positive. And I imagine if you were testing high school kids every day, then you'd find something similar to that too. But I'm just happy to hear that there is high school football, they're willing to start and move forward with that. And I also know that it could end next week or it could end tomorrow.
Yeah.
Depending on that, what happens. And with Labor Day weekend upon us here. There was a more of a push. I heard Fauci say this the other day, that, you know, make sure that you mask up, you do your social distancing.